Grace, mercy, and peace be unto the entire world. It's top of the morning to everyone. I trust that you're up and thankful on this yet another day. It is today. It is the Lord's day. Glory to God. And we are decreeing that it is a great day. We bless on him. Again, trust that you're up and thankful, embracing today in all its fullness, wherever you are around the world. Glory to God. Jesus is Lord, to the glory of God. How excellent is he in all the earth. Let the earth rejoice and be glad in it. It's top of the morning to those of you down there in Jamaica. Glory to God. Yes, I can't wait to get to Jamaica. Yeah, I need a break. Glory to God. Yes, looking forward to getting down there. Looking forward to getting into St. Kitts. Yeah, for the very first time. Glory to God. Yeah, can't wait to get down there. We bless the name of the Lord. God is good. So again, wherever you are around the world, good morning to you. Glory to God. Indeed, I am up and thankful this morning. Glory to God. Yes, up and participating in our early morning prayer. Glory to God. We need to rise early. Glory to God. And we need to pray early. We need to command our day. Glory to God. Yes, to come in alignment. Bless the Lord with what God has in store for us today. Yes, trusting that all is well with you and your family, and you have a lot to give God thanks for. The very fact that you are still breathing, the very fact that you're still amongst the living, yes, the very fact that you're clothed in your right minds. Glory to God. Good morning, Brother Rakeem down there in St. Kitts. The fact that you can truly, get up and stretch and just, oh my God, I'm telling you, there is so much to live for. Glory to God. As I was saying to somebody, and I've been saying, is that as much as life is challenging, as much as you might be going through all sorts of things, glory to God, really, nobody really wants to die. Trust me, nobody wants to die. Glory to God. So giving God thanks for life. Let me just play a little bit of our theme song. Glory to God, this is the theme song, the main theme song, one of them. Glory to God, for real talk. Keep it locked.
You gave me my hands to reach out to men, to show them your love and your perfect plan. You gave me my ears.
Rise and shine this morning.
I can hear your voice so clear. I can hear the cries of sinners, but can I wipe away their tears?
Yes, can we do that?
You gave me my voice to speak your word, to sing all your praises to those who never heard. For more availability, I see hearts that have been broken. So many people to be free. Use me, Lord, to I'm available to you.
Yes, we bless the Lord this morning. Glory to God. Come on, somebody. Let's give him praise this morning. Let's magnify this Lord this morning. Let us exalt his name together, because we serve the awesome God. We serve the almighty God. We come this morning to lift up the name of Jesus. We come this morning to give him praise and to give him glory and to give him honor. Oh, glory to God this morning. There is none like him. No one could compare themselves to him. He is great and greatly to be praised, worthy to be exalted, worthy to be lifted up, worthy to be magnified. When I think about the goodness of Jesus and all that he has done, glory to God, yes, when I roll back the curtains of memories now and then, when I look and I've seen where he's brought us from, glory to God, and where we could have been this morning, we can truly say, if it had not been for the Lord on our side, glory to God, where'd we be this morning? I come to give him praise this morning. I come to give him glory this morning. I come to exalt him this morning. I come to magnify him this morning. Yes, the reason why he created you and I, the reason why he created everything, yes, was to give him praise and to give him glory for his purpose. And this morning we come to fulfill that purpose. Glory to God. Yes, so wherever you are listening to me, wherever you are viewing me, glory to God, yes, you have found yourself amongst the living. Glory to God. Yes, he did not call back his spirit. He did not take back his breath from you. Glory to God. But he allowed you to enter into today. Glory to God. I pray this morning. Yes, that he's the first person you spoke to. Glory to God. Yes, I pray this morning. Yes, that you did not get up complaining, but you got up thanking him. Glory to God. Yes, for allowing you to get up. Yes, not only to get up, but thanking him that you are in your right mind. Glory to God. Yes, thanking him that you can lift your hands, because many persons don't have hands to lift. Glory to God. Yes, many persons don't have a voice because I cannot speak. Glory to God. Yes, but because you have it, because I have it, is enough to give him thanks for. Oh, glory to God. So we thank him this morning for being God. Glory to God. We thank him that there is none like him. No one could compare themselves to him. Come on, somebody. He is a great God. He is the awesome God. He is the almighty God. Yes, he is our healer. He is our deliverer. He is our way maker. He is our shield and butler. He is our hiding place. Oh, we bless on him this morning. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. We bless his holy name from the rising of the sun this morning. My God, I was up and I saw the sun rising this morning. How can we not, yes, pray? Praise God, to oh glory to God. How can we not acknowledge the creator of all things? Yes, he told the sun where to stand and the moon where to hide. Glory to God, the winds and the waves obey him. We bless the name of the Lord. Come on, somebody, we come to magnify the Lord. We come to glorify our King this morning. He is our Kinsman Redeemer this morning. Glory to God. Yes, he is our way maker this morning. He is the line of the tribe of Judah. Come on, somebody, he is God all by himself. himself this morning. He is God alone. Oh, glory to God. From before time began, he sat upon his throne and he ruled and he reigned throughout eternity this morning. He is our shepherd this morning. He is the true vine this morning. He is the restorer of our soul. Come on, somebody. He is the lifter up of our head this morning. Oh, glory to God. And we come, yes, acknowledge the King of Kings. We come to acknowledge the Lord of Lords. Oh, glory to God. I know that when praises goes up, the blessings comes down. I know that praises can shift the atmosphere, making it conducive, yes, for a miracle. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. So we come rejoicing this morning. We come enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. We thank him for yet this another day. Oh, glory to God. Yes, I thank him for the blessings of today. I thank him for the grace of today. I thank him for the mercy of today. Oh, glory to God. I thank him today that he is my peace. He is my joy. He is the very present help in the time of trouble. Glory to God. I don't know what you need him as today, but whatever you need him as, you can call upon him, because he is the I am that I am. He is the all-powerful, the ever-present, the almighty. He is the God that knows all things and is in all things. He is the awesome God. He is holy and he's righteous this morning. He is your kinsman redeemer. He is your chief intercessor. Glory to God. Yes, he is a God that changeth not. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Oh, glory to God. He is the God of Moses, the God of Abraham. Glory to God. Yes, Daniel, God this morning. Yes, he is the on-time God. Yes, he shows up and shows off this morning. Yes, glory to God. He is, yes, the deliverer. He is the Lion of the tribe of Judah. He is, yes, the sea walker, the dead raiser. My God, yes, he is the God that opened the eyes of the blind. Almighty God, I don't care, yes, where they buried you, he can take you out. Glory to God. Yes, I don't care what they've done to you, he can resurrect it. Oh, come on, somebody, let's give him praise because he deserves it. The songwriter says he deserves our praise, he deserves our worship. If that's all that we do, come on, if you cannot praise him now, glory to God, what are you gonna do later on? Because that's all we will do every single day, is to bow down and worship the King. Bow down and worship Yeshua, my God, the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We give him thanks today. We thank him today. Glory to God that he is our shepherd. Glory to God. He is the door. He is the way, the truth, and the life. Glory to God this morning. Yes, he is our shield. He is our hiding place. Glory to God. Yes, he is the one who comforts. Yes, he's the one who guides. And we thank him this morning, Lord. We thank him that he's the one who forgives. Glory to God. He's the one who blotted out our transgressions. He's the one who cleansed us from all unrighteousness. Almighty God, yes, he's the one who saved and delivered us out from the hands of the enemy. Almighty God, some of us was in some things, doing some things. Glory to God, he delivered us out of it this morning. I was saying to those on the prayer line, glory to God, yes, on Zoom, that I am thanking him that he did not allow me to die in my sin. He did not allow me to die in the bed of adultery. Almighty God, he did not allow me to die, glory to God, in my mess, but he redeemed me. Glory to God, yes, it is him who laid down his life. It is him who carried my cross. It is him who took my sin to the grave and buried it there. And this morning I can stand redeemed. It doesn't matter what people want to say about you. It doesn't matter what they want to think. I want to encourage somebody this morning. You have been redeemed. Glory to God, yes. Glory to God, yes, you have been set free. Glory to God, yes, you have been delivered. Glory to God, in whom the Son set free is free indeed. This morning I am giving him thanks for the blood. Oh, glory to God, of Jesus. Come on, some of the blood of Jesus, the blood, the blood, the blood, the blood of Jesus, the blood, not the blood of goats or bullocks, oh, glory to God, turtle doves, but the blood of Jesus, my God, the blood of Jesus, which was shed for the remissions of our sins. No man took his life, but for that which cause he came, glory to God, to fulfill his purpose. Glory to God, yes, and he fulfilled it. Yes, he reigned triumphant. Glory to God, yes, he laid down his life for you and I. When he was on the cross, you and I was on his mind. We weren't even born yet, but he was thinking about us because he knew we were coming. Glory to God, yes. So I come this morning to thank him for the blood of Jesus. What can wash away our sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus, the blood of Yeshua, the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that reaches to the highest mountain and flows to the lowest. lowest valley this morning, hallelujah, at the blood which we can plead and apply over every area of our lives, almighty God. Yes, the blood that's mighty to save. Glory to God. We thank him this morning. Yes, for the many stripes that he took, God, for us in the name of Jesus. The Bible says by his stripes, we are healed this morning, and we believe that we're healed. I don't care what the doctor said. We thank him for the doctors. We thank him for the reports, but we serve the greatest physician ever, glory to God, who can heal and deliver. So we thank you this morning. Yes, that we're being healed from every sickness and disease. Glory to God. Yes, for our God is bigger than the universe. He's bigger than cancer. He's bigger than AIDS. He's bigger than whatever the situation that you're facing. We serve a big God. Think about it. The universe is vast and it's wide. Glory to God. Yes, and he's bigger than it because he took it out of himself. He spoke everything into existence. He's in control of times and seasons. We come to worship that God. It is that God we come to give praise, the one who's alive. Glory to God this morning. I don't know about you, but I know that my Redeemer lives because I spoke to him this morning. Yes. So I know he lives. He rules and he reigns. He cannot be thrown. He cannot be bribed. He's seated far above the heavens. His eyes running to and fro. He knows all things. He knows the mind of every person. Glory to God. Yes. He knows what I'm thinking. He knows what you're thinking. He knows what the prime minister is thinking. He knows what everybody's thinking. He knows our thoughts even before we know them. That's how awesome he is this morning. He is the giver of life. He's the sustainer of it this morning. He is our battle axe. Oh, glory to God this morning. I don't know who you know him as this morning, but I know him as healer. I know him as my way maker. I know him as my provider. I know him as the God who has restored my soul. I know he's the God who sustains all things. Oh, glory to God. I know him as a merciful God, a God of compassion, a God of many chance in the name of Jesus. Yes, I know him. Glory to God. Yes, almighty God. Yes, as the God who is more than enough, the one who's more than able to do exceedingly abundantly above all I can think, ask, or imagine. Oh, glory to God this morning. I know him as my shepherd. Glory to God. Yes, the Bible says, yea, though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we shall fear no evil. This morning, mighty God, we have no fear. Glory to God, but we have boldness, almighty God. We were not created to worry or to fear. So I come against the spirit of anxiety. The Bible said we should not be anxious for nothing, but in all things to pray and supplication to make our requests known unto the almighty God in the name of Jesus. So that is the God I am worshiping this morning. That is the God that I bow down to this morning. Oh, glory to God. Yes, we've searched the heavens high and the earth below, and there's none like him this morning. No one could compare themselves to him. Glory to God. Yes, when we found ourselves with our backs against the wall, he made a way. Therefore, he is the way maker. He is the miracle working God. I thank him today that he is a God that delivered us out of our circumstances. I am thanking him that he's healed every broken heart. I am thanking him that the oppressed is set free. I am thanking him this morning. Glory to God for saving and delivering, oh God, and healing in the name of Jesus this morning. I'm thanking him that he is in control, and I come to lift my voice and I come to give him praise. Oh, glory to God. I come to give him thanksgiving. I'm thanking him for the blessings of today because it is a blessed day today. I am thanking him for the shield of protection today, that no evil shall befall us. The sun shall not strike us by day, nor the moon by night. Oh, glory to God. Yes, I thank in him today for dealing with the enemies and our adversaries. Oh, glory to God. Back every force of darkness and cripple and paralyze every plan of the enemy. Almighty God, in the name of Jesus, we intercept every weapon of mass destruction that the enemy has set out, every plan that the enemy executed throughout the night. We overturn it in the name of Jesus. We veto it. Glory to God. And we say it shall not stand. I decree and I declare today we shall not be ambushed in the name of Jesus, but we are more than conquerors. Oh, glory to God. Yes, we're above only and not beneath, blessed and can never be cursed. Glory to God. So we come to give God praise today. We come to worship him today. We come to exalt him today because he is our king. Yes, he is our savior and our Lord. He is our battle our acts, Almighty God, and we give him thanks, glory to God, today, and we bless on him. We thank him today for every soul, yes, that will be saved today. Today, in the name of Jesus, we thank him for every backslider that's coming home today. We thank him for every relationship, glory to God, that's being healed today. I thank him, glory to God, for closed doors. I thank him for shutting some doors that needed to shut. Yes, he says, behold, I've placed before you an open door. I thank him today for an open door. I thank him today for favor in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I thank him today for the next level. Oh, glory to God, in the name, I give him thanks. I give him praise because of who he is this morning. I give him glory because of who he is this morning. I give him praise because of who he is this morning. I lift my voice and I worship him this morning because of who he is. He is Jehovah Jireh. He is Jehovah Nissi. He is Jehovah Elohim. He is Jehovah Rapha. He is, glory to God, Jehovah Mekadesh, Jehovah Tiskanu. He is, oh, glory to God, the Lord God Almighty, almighty and strong. Lift up your head, O ye gates, my God, and be lifted up, ye everlasting doors, that the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? He is the Lord God Almighty. He's mighty in battle, Almighty God. And that's why we know that the battle is not ours, but is his. And we thank him for the victory today. Glory to God, the victory over sin, sickness, and disease, the victory over every plot of the adversary, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. I pray today, mighty God, for the spirit of endurance, oh, glory to God, to rest upon your people today, that we'll endure, Almighty God, because we know it's not by might nor by power, but by your spirit, glory to God. So we thank you today that we are overcomers, Almighty God. Hallelujah. We thank you for eagle's wings. We thank you for hind's feet. Glory to God. We give you thanks and we give you praise and we give you glory, Almighty God, as we abide in you and you in us, oh God. Whatever you're doing today, God, don't do it without us, as we make ourselves available to you. We give you our hands. Use us, Lord, for your glory, for that which you purpose for us on this day. God, we say, let it be done today. Let our lives bring glory to you. Our conversation, our thoughts, in the name of Jesus, let the reverence of the Lord continue to be with us on today. We thank you for the Spirit of the Lord. Our Holy Spirit, we give you preeminence to lead and to guide and to direct us into all truth, to empower us to do that which is right, to convict us, Almighty God, of sin, that we may be able to repent quickly, in the name of Jesus. I pray today, God, that you'll seal every occasion to sin with the blood of Jesus. Help us today to guard our hearts with all diligence, for out of it proceeds the issue of life. This morning, we thank you for the sash of truth. Yes, we pray this morning, keep our tongue from speaking evil and our lips from being deceitful, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. We thank you, Lord, for freedom. Yes, freedom to worship you, because we know, mighty God, there's some countries that they can't worship you freely. Help us not to take it for granted, but help us to use it wisely, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Father God, I thank you, Lord, for restoring families. I thank you for healing our land. I thank you for delivering our children. I thank you for protecting them, in the name of Jesus. We give you thanks. I thank you this morning, mighty God, what the enemy meant for evil, that you'll turn it around for your glory. For your glory, Lord, let it be done. So for your will, let it be done. Hallelujah. So give you thanks. And we give you praise this morning. And we give him glory this morning. Oh, glory to God. We serve a good God. We serve an awesome God. We serve the Almighty God this morning. Oh, glory to God. When we think about the goodness of Jesus and all that he has done for us this morning, our soul cries out, thank you, Lord, for saving us. Thank you for delivering us. Thank you for setting us free. Oh, we bless on him this morning. For whom the Son is set free is free indeed this morning. We bless the Lord. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Once again, rise and shine, for the light has come And the glory of the Lord is risen upon us this morning. I won't be before you long this morning, but we just want to greet today with great anticipation. Glory to God. Yes. Glory to God. Just giving God thanks. Oh, God, sometimes I don't think we thank God enough. Yeah. I don't think we thank God enough at times. Sometimes I don't think how we don't, sometimes I think we don't realize how privileged we are. Yeah, you know, we take things for granted. Glory to God. And I want to share with us just for a little bit as it just comes in my spirit, and I was going to do it. And then I said I wasn't going to do it, but it's, I'm reminded. So let me just do this for a little bit. Glory to God. I want to share, just read a portion of scripture, probably tomorrow on Word Day. I will come with more in-depth word from it. But I want us to go to the book of Numbers. Glory to God. Yes. Numbers chapter 11. And just please indulge me for a little bit. Glory to God. Good morning, Sister Karen. Yes, thank you, Jesus, for saving, for redeeming, and setting us free today. Yes, indeed, we have to give him thanks. And we bless the name of the Lord. From the book of Numbers, chapter 11, we got to be careful when we complain. Yeah. You see, we are a people of, we complain, we are murmurers. You see, no matter how much God is blessing us, we still complain. No matter what he's doing, we complain. When it's cold, we complain. When it's hot, we complain. We have much, we complain. We have it, like I'm telling you, we're a bunch of complainers. So from the book of Numbers, glory to God, let us read for a little bit. And again, as I said, I will probably pick up some more on Word Day as the Spirit of the Lord leads. From the book of Numbers, I'm reading from the New King James Version, just a few verses. And then again, as I said, we'll see where the Spirit of the Lord goes, and then we'll take it from there. Glory to God. Now, when the people complained, it displeased the Lord. I want to let us know, when we complain, it displeased the Lord. Glory to God. Yes, when we complain, it displeases him. You know why? Because when we complain, it's like an insult to him. You understand? It's just like when we murmur, it's like an insult. It's like us saying, you know what, God, you are not able to do what you said that you can do. You're not able to deal with my situation. You're not able. You don't, you don't have the power. You're not able to do it. Glory to God. So the Bible says, now, when the people complain, it displeases God. So I want to let us know, when we complain, and even if you don't open your mouth and say it in your thoughts, he knows your thoughts. That's the thing. Glory to God. You can sit beside me. You could be thinking, or you could be watching me right now. You could be thinking all sorts of things. I'm not hearing you, but guess what? He hears you. So even when we're complaining in our mind, he knows we're complaining. Glory to God. It displeased the Lord, for the Lord heard it. Yeah. And his anger was aroused. So the fire of the Lord burned among them and consumed some in the outskirts of the camp. Wow. Hear what happened to people who complain? Then the people cried out to Moses. And when Moses prayed to the Lord, the fire was quenched. Wow. So he called the name of the place Tabertha. Somebody could pronounce that properly for me, because the fire of the Lord had burned among them. You see what happens when people complain? It angers the Lord. It says the fire of the Lord burned among them and consumed some. Wow. Now the mixed multitude who were among them yielded to intense craving. Watch your craving. Some of us, it's our craving that's going to cause us to miss the mark. Those appetites you crave for, you're craving for sex, you're craving for money. Yes, you crave for money. What's your craving for attention? What's your craving to be seen? What's your craving to be exalted and to be recognized? Be careful of your cravings. Yep, our cravings will cause us to open ourselves up to the enemy to use us. It says here, now the multitude mixed themselves, whom were among them, yield to intense cravings. So the children of Israel also wept again and said, who will give us meat to eat? Oh, come on, somebody. They're complaining. Ah, glory to God. Yes, that, you know, Moses took them out of Egypt. You understand? And now, glory to God, you know, they're complaining, they're murmuring. Imagine God take you out of your situation. You know, just think about it sometimes. We're so ungrateful. God delivered us out of some abusive situation. God delivers us out of some habits. God delivers us out of some things that would have killed and destroyed us. And when we come out, we complain and we murmur, glory to God. I want to let you know that God is displeased. Glory to God. He's angry when we complain. He's angry when we murmur. He's angry at the ungrateful. We bless the name of the Lord. They went on to say, we remember fish which we ate freely in Egypt. Good God Almighty. When you're in Egypt, you understand? When they're in Egypt, you understand? They lash them. They treat them all sorts of weird. You understand? When you're in your Egypt, they laugh at you. They abuse you. They take you for granted. Glory to God. When you're in Egypt, you bounce a boat and you were like a wretched and God delivered you. Now you're going to say, you remember when you're in Egypt? Now you're going to try to compare where you are to Egypt. Glory to God. That's an insult to God. They said, we remember the fish we ate freely in Egypt, the cucumbers and the melons and the leeks and the onions and the garlic. Oh, God. But now our whole being is dried up. There is nothing at all except this manna before our eyes. Imagine now, God took them out of Egypt. Even although they were eating those things, they were eating under affliction. Oh, glory to God. They were being afflicted. Oh, we bless the name of the Lord. I want to encourage somebody today. Your future is brighter than your Egypt. You cannot compare cucumbers and garlic and onions. Glory to God. You cannot compare your life that you were living in sin to where you're going. That is ungrateful. Glory to God. Many of us who were used to money when we were in Egypt because we trafficked drugs and we used to enough money and all of that. Now we're saying, oh, you know, when I was in the world, you know, I had money and you know, I had my money. I could pay my bills. And now, Moses, look, you took me out of trafficking drugs. You took me out of there. And now I have no money. Now I have to be sitting and wondering. Glory to God. The devil is a liar. Let us refuse. We cannot live in Egypt destined to the promised land. Glory to God. Be careful of the cravings. Be careful of your cravings for fish. Be careful of your cravings for cucumber because it will bring you back to Egypt. Be careful of your cravings for money. Yes, and like some of us too licky. And because we're licky, we're going to go back to Egypt. The Bible says, woe be unto them who return to Egypt for help. We bless the name of the Lord. Glory to God. So they're complaining now and saying, oh, we don't want this manna. Glory to God. My God, help me, Lord. Now the manna was like, coordinated seed and its color like the color of bdellium. The people went about and gathered it, ground it on millstones, or beat it in mortar, cooked it in pans, and made cakes of it. And its taste was like the taste of pastry prepared with oil. And when the dew fell on the camp in the night, the manna fell on it. So God was providing them food. But guess what? They're never used to this kind. Glory to God. Be careful of the old familiar things. It will cause you to neglect the new. Come on, somebody. Glory to God. Yes, the old way, the old appetites will cause you not to embrace the new, what is good for you, glory to God. They've never ate this kind of food before, glory to God. They're not used to this kind of food. Again, be careful of the craving of your past. Glory to God. Yes. Be careful of that craving of the past. It will destroy you and cause you to lose your way. We bless the name of the Lord. Glory to God. So they complained. Then Moses heard the people weeping throughout their families, everyone at the door of his tent. And the anger of the Lord was greatly aroused. God was becoming angry now. He provided them this food, which was good for them, but they were complaining. Moses also was displeased. Glory to God. So now Moses is becoming angry now and displeased because they were displeased with God. So Moses said to the Lord, "Why have you afflicted your servant? And why have I not found favor in your sight that you have laid the burden of all these people on me? Did I conceive all these people?" So Moses saying to God, listen, these are your people. Never me conceived them. So why you put all them burden upon me? Why am I now hearing all of this? Glory to God. Did I beget them that you should say to me, carry them in your bosom? As a guardian carries a nursing child to the land which you swore to their fathers. Glory to God. Now Moses is saying to God, where am I to get meat to give all these people? Because guess what? No, them want meat. Them want fish because that's what they used to, that's what they're complaining about. Glory to God. Now that I'm out here, I don't have no fish. I don't have no money. Yes, now that I'm out here, I don't have a good bed. I lost everything because you let me leave everything in Egypt. And now I want this. I want this. You know, just think about it. Now they're complaining to Moses. Your fault. It's your fault. This and that. Now, what do you brought us out here to die. And they started, oh, good God Almighty, stop the complaining. God hates it. Again, as I said, be careful of the craving that you're having. You know, when pregnant women are pregnant, they have certain cravings. Some of them is weird. Be careful of the craving. The craving will cost you your spiritual life and even eventually your spirit, your physical life. That craving for sex, that craving for money will cause you to steal. The craving for money will cause you to deceive and try to trick people. You understand? Yes, you trick people to giving you things. Yes, you call this a line, that a line, because you have a crave for money. You have a crave for good life. You're jealous and you want to live like other people. So you be now that craving for money caused you to manipulate. You see how the craving can open all sorts of doors, all sorts of avenues. Be careful of your craving. What you're craving for. Be careful that that craving for fish and cucumbers that you used to eat. Glory to God. Yes, it's not suffice for where you're going. So Moses now is saying to God, where am I to get meat? The people that want fish, glory to God. It's so, like some of us, you understand, we're preaching the undiluted word, but people want prophecy. They want you to tell them, say, they're going to get husband. Father God, they want you to come and tell them, say, you understand, go down there, they're going to find a bag of money. They want you to tell them that this is going to happen. God Almighty, where am I supposed to get that word to give them? That's not what you told me to give them. So they start murmuring and they start saying, Vivian, you preach the gospel to me. And now that I'm a Christian, I can't pay my rent. Now that I'm a Christian, my husband left me. Now that I'm a Christian, this is happening to me, Vivian. Yes, so now I'm coming to God. God, what am I to do? Now that they come to know you, they lose their house. They're weeping. God is angry at the ungrateful. We bless the name of the Lord. So Moses is saying to God, for they weep all over me, saying, give us meat that we may eat. So now Moses feeling the pressure of the people. He's saying to God, I'm not able to bear all these people alone because the burden is too heavy for me if you treat me like this. So Moses was saying to God, please, I better kill me here and now. If I found favor in your sight, that means Moses saying, God, me can't anger this no more because guess what? I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to do nothing out of the way. So therefore, guess what? Now, if the only way for me to release me from this people and this burden, kill me now. Do not let me see my wretchedness. Come on, somebody. Again, be careful of your cravings. Come on, somebody. So the Lord said to Moses, and he gave Moses instructions, gather to me 70 men of elders of Israel, whom you know to be elders of the people and office over them. Bring them to the tabernacle of meetings, that they may stand there with you. Then I will come down and talk to you there. I will take off the spirit that is upon you and will put the same upon them, and they shall bear the burden of the people with you. Glory to God. So now God is saying to Moses, go get some other people then. All right. Hey, I'm going to tell you. So guess what? You're not going to bear it alone, Moses. Let me make them bear it with you. Glory to God. And they shall bear the burden of the people with you, that you may not bear it yourself alone. Then you shall say to the people, consecrate yourself for tomorrow, and you shall eat meat. Hey, I know. A meat you want, a meat you gonna get. You understand? A rum bar you want, rum you gonna get. Yep, a money you want, money you gonna get. Glory to God. He says, and you shall eat meat, for you have wept in the hearing of the Lord, saying, who will give us meat to eat? For it was well with us in Egypt. God was gonna deal with them. You understand? God was about to deal with them. We bless the name of the Lord. Oh, God Almighty, I need to leave some for tomorrow. Listen, God was going to, your meat you want, a meat you're going to get. Glory to God. You're not satisfied with what God will give you? Watch. Watch. And I mean, just to get ahead of myself, because it's sake of time, and I'm going to come back tomorrow. As we continue to read, and you know the story, God did give them meat. Them eat until them vomit and dead. Oh, yes. Therefore, the Lord will give you meat and you shall eat. Listen to this. You shall eat not one day, nor 2 days, nor 5 days, nor 10 days, nor 20 days, but for a whole month until it comes out of your nostril and become lotmus to you, because you have despised the Lord who is among you, and have wept before him, saying, why did we ever come out of Egypt? You see, because you complain and you say, now you're used to this at Egypt, you're used to that, you're used to your money, you're used to your money, you used to your liquor, you used to your own thing. God is gonna make you get it till you vomit, till it's a come out all part of you. You understand? Because you complain. So guess what? I meet you one, I meet you again. You're gonna say, you're gonna eat it till you're sick and vomit and die. Be careful of your cravings. Be careful of your cravings. Come on, somebody. Glory to God. I want to skip down to verse 31. I'm going to come back tomorrow and really get into this. Now a wind went out from the Lord and brought quail from the sea and left them fluttering near the camp, about a day's journey on this side and about a day's journey on the other side, all around the camp, about 2 cubits above the surface of the ground. And the people stayed up all night, all day, and all the next day and gathered the quail. He who gathered least gathered 10 homers, and they spread them out for themselves all around the camp. But while the meat was still between their teeth, before it was chewed, the wrath of God was arose against, Lord Jesus, have mercy. Be careful how you're complaining. Be careful. The cravings of Egypt, don't call to kindle the anger of the Lord against you. Be careful when you're murmuring about when you used to have, or where you used to be, or when you're used to this. Be careful, because it will kindle the wrath of God against you. The Bible said, and they spread them out for themselves and all around the camp. But while the meat was still between their teeth, before it was even chewed, the wrath of God was arose against the people. And the Lord struck the people with a very great plague. Be careful. You see, the thing about it, you know, we cannot. Jesus said, I did not come to abolish what happened in the Old Testament to fulfill it. It's the same God. God is angry with complainers. He's angry with murmurers. He's angry with the ungrateful. Glory to God. How could you deny and compare your past life to where God has taken you? Come on now. It angered God. Glory to God. God gave it to them enough. We bless the Lord. Glory to God. And then eat it till I'm sick, till it come out to them nostril. Glory to God. This is Bible. Even before them chew it. Come on. Be careful. I am warning us. Oh, glory to God. Let us not compare Egypt to where we are. Glory to God. Because it's going to anger God against you. The anger of God is going to kindle against you. The Bible says the Lord struck the people with a very great plague. And they were buried. They died. Glory to God. And they died and were buried because they yield to cravings. I want to let you something know. The devil has, we got to control our appetite. We got to control our cravings. Glory to God. We cannot allow the enemy, glory to God, to give us the appetite of Egypt. To remind us, this is what the people were doing. They were complaining to Moses because they're saying, Moses, I was used to my fish. I was used to the cucumber. Yes, you were eating steak. Yes, you were eating lobster. Yes, you were eating things, but you were eating it under affliction. You were eating under pain. You were eating it under pressure. Glory to God. And God took you out of that. And yes, you might not have meat, but he's providing that which you need. Don't allow the cravings to cost you your relationship. Don't allow the cravings to cost God to be angry that he sends a plague upon you and consume you. Oh, we bless the name of the Lord this morning. Oh, come on, somebody. Be careful of your cravings. Be careful of your cravings. Glory to God, to be exalted by man. Be careful of your cravings for a status quo. Because when you have a craving for thing enough, you start to, and then you see you don't get it, you start to manipulate because you remember when you were there. You remember when you were the CEO. You remember when you were this. You remember, oh, people did this and people did that for you. And now that God took you out of that and he's training you, you're saying, if it was this, I would, no. That's the craving of Egypt. And the more you start craving Egypt, the more you're going to complain. Oh, this Christian thing is not for me. Glory to God. Up here, Ipurga, this Christian thing is not for me. Many of us have said it. Glory to God. When we weren't Christians, we were able to pay with bill. You understand? Many of us, you know, we have a big money because, you know, we owe thousands of dollars, millions of dollars. And sometimes when you have to wait upon somebody now to give you a dollar, when you have to wait, you start saying, oh, you know, back in the days when I had my money, we never have to wait upon nobody. That's comparing where you are now to Egypt. That God is angry. Yep. He's angry. And God is angry with some of us. Yeah. Yes, when you were in Egypt, you were paying your rent, but you were sleeping around, making your body like a little mattress. And God took you out of that, and you want to tell me no? You understand? You can't pay your rent. No, you can't trust God to provide rent and food for you. You'd rather to say, go back and be a mattress so you can pay your rent. And God didn't, and you expect God not to be angry when he did so much to deliver you out of that? Come on, somebody. Glory to God. That's going to kindle the fire and the anger of God You understand what I'm trying to say? Some of us manipulated our way out to pay our bills, and God took you out of that. Glory to God. And all you have to do is wait upon him. He said, those that wait upon the Lord, he says, I'm your provider. God is teaching us to wait. He's teaching us now that when you're in Egypt, you thought you had to take and fend for yourself, but I'm responsible for you. You gave your life over to me. I am the driver now. I know where I'm going. I know what I want to do. And that's why I said a person who trusts the Lord is a person who surrendered everything to God. Come on, somebody, this morning, we give him praise. So how now, glory to God, you want to compare yourself to that? You lie your way out. We lie our way out. We manipulate our way out to get what we have. Some of us, you understand, the car that we have, a lie, we lie, and lie to the bank, and lie to this, and all sort of something, and God deliver you out, and you don't have a car now. And you're saying, oh, you wish you had a car. That means you wish you were still your lying ways. You wish you were still a manipulator. You wish you were still a deceiver. And that's what angers God. Glory to God. Come on, somebody. The people angered God because their cravings caused them to get God angry. And God, guess what? Oh, God, be careful of the requests you make to God, enough, because God answered them, enough. God did answer them. Yes, you want meat, it did answer them. But guess what? This very thing what them want, it killed them. The very thing that you long for, Egypt, mine and it take you out and bring you 6 feet under. Mine and it carry you to the grave. Oh, come on, somebody. Oh, yes. Mine the craving, you understand, to do this. Don't carry you to the grave. God allow you not for contract AIDS. God allow you not for contract no terminal sickness when you're out there sleeping around and you desire because you want money for God to do that. You might contract that AIDS or something and it carry you to your grave. Come on, somebody. The Bible said it. They died and were buried because they yield to their cravings. Glory to God. Come on. I'm speaking truth. Be careful of the cravings that you have, because God will give you your request now. Glory to God. But are you able to bear the consequence when he gives you that meat and you sit down and your teeth and your teeth and your drink and your drink now, and you say, yes, it feels nice. Oh, yes. See, Moses, this is what I'm used to. This is what I like. Only to hear you go to the doctor, my good God. Yes. All of a sudden, you don't feel well and you go to the doctor. Yes, I'm talking truth. Yes, you go to the doctor now and the doctor sends you to go get an x-ray, and the doctor says, oh, I'm sorry to let you know, glory to God, your liver is damaged, and there's nothing that we can do. You have 3 weeks to live. You're craving that you wanted cause you now to contract a terminal illness, and now you're calling upon God as your healer. Let me tell you something, you're calling upon God to have mercy, but yet still, when he was having mercy, you wanted Egypt. So let me let you, and God, you don't talk, oh, good God. Sometimes I wonder, when some people die, is it because they wanted a craving and God gave it to them and it caused them to lose their life? Be careful when you're complaining. Be careful what you're asking God for, because it will end up killing you. Come on. We give God praise this morning. Again, as I said, make sure that in your situation, that your cravings is not leading you to Egypt, but it's pushing you forward into your future. Yeah? Because the appetite of Egypt does not work in where we're going. And that's why we need to get rid of those cravings. We're single, you don't have a man, you need to ask the Lord to suppress that craving for sex, because you don't want to ask him to take it away. Because when you get to the future and you have your husband, you're going to want to enjoy him in every aspect of your life. So you're not going to ask him to take away the feeling of sex or not. Just ask him to give you self-control. Ask him to be able to control that craving. Glory to God. Because that craving is a godly craving, because he gave us feelings. You understand what I'm saying? So don't. But the cravings that will cause you to go back to Egypt, you understand? Ask God to deliver you from them, the ones that needs to be delivered from. Tell him to deliver you from them. The craving of gossiping, the craving of biting, the craving of pride, the craving of money. Yes, you love money because you're used to money, and money used to rule you. You understand? So therefore, now you not have it, so you want it to rule you again. So you, oh, come on, somebody. Help us, Lord. We bless the name of the Lord this morning. Our cravings. What are you craving for this morning? Yeah. You know what our cravings should be? For more of God. Our cravings should be for more desire. We're craving for the word. We're craving, you understand, for prayer. We're craving for godly fellowship. We're craving, yeah, to be used by God. Yes, we're craving. That's what we should be craving for. You know when you're craving, them say you're craving, you just eat. I go on to your craving, your belly on the bottom. Well, let our belly on the bottom for the things of God. Let our belly on the bottom, you understand, for God out there and witness. Let our belly on the bottom, let them say we just too craving. We're too craving for love prayer. Let them say we're too craving for the word. Every minute we're just in at the word. We're too craving. Yes, I'd rather to be more craving. I'd rather them call me craving for prayer, craving for the word, craving for God evangelize than craving for the things of Egypt. That's the appetite we want to develop. The appetite, grow together, please God. The appetite that bring God, the cravings that bring God's glory. We bless the name of the Lord. Those are the type of cravings. Me no want of craving for jealousy. Me no want of craving for gossip and listen to people and backbite people. No, those are the cravings of Egypt. We bless the name of the Lord. Those are cravings that will anger God and cause his anger to be poured out on us. So again this morning, let us be mindful of the cravings. Yes, Brother Rakim. Lord, he's saying, help me to crave more of you. Yes, we need to crave more of God, more of his presence. We need to crave for more worship. Glory to God. Yes, my sister Karen, appetite for Jesus and his word, his fellowship. That's what we crave, more presence. We crave to be used by God. We crave to be vessels of honor, holy and acceptable unto the Lord. And that's why we got to monitor our appetite at all times. That's why as believers, we're not supposed to licky-licky and nyammy-nyammy. We have to know what our cravings, how to satisfy our cravings. And that's why it's so important that when we have cravings, we know who we're listening to, who is speaking to us, which voice are we following? Come on, somebody. We give him praise this morning and we give him glory this morning. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. Our glory to God this morning. Yes, our cravings. It can cost us our life spiritually. And even physically too. Yeah, you're murmuring and you're complaining. Trust God. As I said on yesterday, a life that is surrendered to God is saying what? I trust you, Lord. I take myself away out of the driver's seat. Oh, what a word this morning. Wow. Cravings. Yeah, let every man check himself. Yeah. You know, sometimes you say, oh, I have a craving for fish. I have a craving for meat. I have a craving for this type of food. You know what I mean? So we have cravings. We're just going to make sure that our cravings don't lead us back to Egypt. Because guess what? It can cost us our lives. All right? So there you have it. Let's play a little bit of a theme song. And then we're going to get out of here. My God, what a word.
You gave me my
what a word on this Saturday morning. We give God thanks.
Reach out to me.
He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying.
Show them your love and your perfect plan. You gave me my ears. I can hear your voice so clear. Sinners, but cannot wipe away their tears.
Oh, we bless him this morning.
You gave me my voice.
I'm thanking him for my voice this morning.
To speak your
yes,
word,
to speak his word.
To sing all your praises to those who so many people to be free.
Oh, yes.
Oh, Lord, I'm available
yes.
to you.
I'm available to you today, God. Available to you. Glory to God. We just want to thank the Lord this morning. for speaking to us the way he did, glory to God, through his word. We give him praise and we give him glory. Yes, because he's the one that has spoken, glory to God, and your servant has heard, and we will apply the word accordingly, glory to God, to the areas of our lives that needs be. We bless the Lord this morning. Glory to God. Before I go, glory to God, I just want to announcement that we will be here tomorrow by God's grace. It's word day in the house, and I'm going to continue from where I left off. I just kind of touched the surface, but I'm going to go in depth. Our cravings can cost us our lives. We bless the name of the Lord. We got to be mindful of how we complain and how we murmur. Even if we don't do it verbally in our thoughts, God knows our thoughts, glory to God, even before we even think them. We bless the name of the Lord, glory to God. This evening, Real Talk Committee is going to be gathering for a day of fun and fellowship. We will be coming live with a bit of that segment. For those of you who are not here, but you're across the globe, that's a part of us. We want to include you. So we'll be videotaping it live. In and out, some clips showing you as we come to fellowship. Glory to God, you'll get to see some of the members that you don't normally see. Glory to God, on the front line. So whether by video or picture, we're going to be sharing them with you. Glory to God. God has called us to live a balanced life. So we're going to gather today, glory to God, to fellowship with one another. We're spread out across the city. So we're going to come together, glory to God, for that. So we'll be showing you a little bit of that later this evening. Again, I just want to announce to save the date in September. Glory to God, it is our anniversary on Real Talk. Glory to God, it's also my birthday. Glory to God. So I want you to save the date, September the 17th. Glory to God, we are going to be coming out and celebrating that which God has done. Glory to God, it's Real Talk and that which he continues to do. We want you to be a part of it. Those of you who are not in Canada, glory to God, yes, we'll make a way that you can also participate and be able to, just recap with us, glory to God, go over some new stuff. Maybe leading up to September, what I like to do is do some reposting of some videos or some messages or some shows, just for you to see what we've been doing over the years, glory to God. There's some really good shows that we did, glory to God. One of the ones that that stood up most to me was the one with Mothers Against Gun Violence. Very touchy one. It always, is in my thoughts. Glory to God. I think also in this year, the year that we're going to be celebrating now, I think we did the Endless Love segment, which is a very, good segment. So there's many, many devotions and all that stuff, worship time that we've done. So we're going to recap, relive some of those, share them with you as we enter, glory to God, in the month of September by God's grace. God is doing a new thing. The other day, he told me that it's the next level. Glory to God. Yes, I'm about to get to the next level of increase. And I just trust him as I've allowed him to now be the driving force. I am just sitting in the passenger seat, glory to God, with my mouth closed. I will speak when the Lord tells me to speak, as the Holy Spirit give me utterance, glory to God. And I'll write down what he's saying, that I'll be able to follow his instructions. Glory to God. So save the day, September the 17th. My birthday is September the 11th, but this event is going to be on the 17th. I would just ask you to come out and celebrate with us, glory to God. That which God has been doing and will continue to do through us on this platform. Glory to God, as we also prepare to do some live gatherings. All right. So again, you want to save the date for that. All right. So God bless you. God keep you. Thank you for including Real Talk in your devotion this morning. Many of us don't understand. Devotions is not just from Monday to Friday. Every day we should have a devotion. Every day we should be praying. Glory to God. Yes, we must start our day with prayer. We must end it with prayer. Glory to God, with thanksgiving. So I count it a privilege for you stopping by, whether you did for 2 minutes, whether you just popped in and pop out. God bless you. God keep it. Those of you who will watch later, our YouTube followers and viewers, glory to God. God bless you. God keep you. It was a privilege serving you this morning with clean hands and a pure. I myself, glory to God, have been encouraged by the word this morning. I myself, glory, especially somebody like me, you understand? You know how when you're used to money, 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 glory to God, yes. And when you run out of money, you don't worry because you know where money's gonna come from. You know how to make it quick. Glory to God, it's hard for us to be constrained to a particular budget, but I'd rather be constrained in the hand of God than to return to Egypt, to my former lifestyle. Glory to God, yes. So I know this word is for me too, to remind me, listen, girl, don't even compare yourself when you're doing that up and down. Don't even compare yourself when people are caught. You see, that's the thing God reminded me. You know what God reminded me at one day? He said, listen, when you're in Egypt, you were popular. Everybody wants you. Everybody wants to grow on you because guess what? They know what you can do, how you can let them make money, how you could do this. So you were popular. But guess what, honey? When you come to the kingdom, it's not about popular. Oh, God Almighty. It's not about popularity status. Yeah, come on. I'm telling you, God had to go me down one day and say, girl, listen, it's not about that. Yes, it's a different avenue right now. Glory to God, yes. So again, this word is for me. I receive it. And I've always said to people, you know, when God wants to talk to me, I don't know about you, he uses my own mouth, glory to God, because I can't block out myself. You understand? But if you talk to me, I can block out, you know, and I could turn off or whatever. But when he's using my own mouth to speak to me, guess what? I hear him loud and clear. Bless the Lord. So I receive this word as well, glory to God, for myself, and I'd apply it to the area of my life also. So I am not exempt from what God has said to us this morning. We bless the name of the Lord. And truly, as ministers of the gospel, the word must first deal with us before we can deliver it. And that's why when we're preaching, we don't say you, you, uno, uno. We say we. You understand? You and I. Glory to God. So be careful of those preachers. We always say you, you, uno for this, uno wicked, uno this. No, we're all wicked. We're all liars. We're all deceivers. We're all hypocrites and backbiters. Glory to God, yes. Yes, and God deliver us. So don't say, oh no, oh no, oh no, need for change. You ever go to some service, yes, and you hear somebody saying, tell them, that you for tell them. Glory to God. Now, I was sitting in the company of somebody yesterday, and she's talking about, oh, pure demon, this demon, that church, and some demon sitting beside you. And I was there, somebody said, yeah, yeah, you were probably one of them too. You know, remember, probably you're still a demon, still waiting to be delivered to a religious demon. Oh, come on, somebody. I trust me, I wanted to really rise up and say, you know, cut that out, because trust me, you understand? And so let us not be quick to, you know, everything, you, yeah, all of us were once that. We've all sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Yeah, so let us not point fingers. All right, so God bless you. God keep you wherever you are around the world. Remember, you have the heart of a champion, the mind of an overcomer, the spirit of more than a conqueror, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Remember, you are a lit candle. Go out and light your world. Go out and love on somebody, embrace somebody. Yes, buy somebody something to eat, buy some, just do something that when you finish and done today, you can say, God, you're glorified. All right, big up to all my evangelists who's going to be on the streets. A beautiful Saturday. Yep, God bless you as you continue. Yes, to hand out that track as you continue to lift your voice over communities. God keep you and bless you. Glory to God for those of you who are going into institutions today. Glory to God, whether to do a Bible study or conduct a service. The Lord go with you. The Lord protect you and keep you. Glory to God, yes. So whatever you do today, make sure that God is glorified in it. We bless the name of the Lord. So again, have yourself a wonderful day. See you back. See you later, actually, at our event, glory to God, as we come together by God's grace. Blessings.